It's been a little while in the making. Naho Kuhanohano award winning world champions. It is awesome to have them be on this stage in a sold out Hawaii theater. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Pure Heart!
Every time you go, girl, let you know, causes me to just a little bit crazy without you. What am I gonna do? Said I'm crazy without you. Things you put me through. Sit all alone waiting by the phone just to hear a call from you. Though it's not the same just to hear your name, what am I gonna do? But I'll be alright every day and night if you could stay with me. Every time you go, girl, let you know, causes me to be just a little bit crazy, crazy.
Thanks, guys. Thanks, Jake and Lopaka, for being here and agreeing to come on and sing it.
Thank you, man. You know, John worked really hard, you know, his whole crew at HiSessions. I mean, John, he's the star of the show, but he was also picking up lunch today, dropping it off. It was like the coolest thing, man. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Jake. Appreciate it. Hey, if you don't mind, I wanted to... this is... not just nostalgic. Everyone that I've been talking to has been talking about how it's a nostalgia, you know, because we're 20 years plus into this, and people listened to us back in the 90s, which doesn't seem like a long time ago, but it's a long time ago. And so I just wanted to tell a little bit of the story of how we even became who we are, you know, like the band. I always tell people we have the nerdiest story in all of Hawaiian music. Because Jake and I met because we were in student council together. That's right.
Student gov, baby.
Student gov. And he helped me buy my first ukulele. And then, so soon thereafter, I had my sophomore banquet. And maybe 3 days before my sophomore banquet, I got dumped. So, oh wow, people have, it's okay, I'm married now. It's all good. But anyway. So I called Jake and I'm like, hey, Jake, you know, why don't you use my bid and come as my date? And we're going to play for everybody. We're going to play, do like a talent show thing. And he agreed. So Jake was my date to my...
I was his rebound.
Yeah, that's right. So anyway, yeah, that's
but
how we started.
But don't worry, because I'm married now, too.
That's right. And so yeah, that's the story of how Jake and I met. And actually, I have a picture that I wanted to show on the screen if it comes up. This is, yeah. just 20 odd years ago. And there's two things that's crazy about this. The first one is, I don't know how 18-year-old Jake looks older than 40-year-old Jake. But somehow that happened. I don't know how that is. But the other crazy thing about this picture is, if you look at it, we can't really see the date, but the date is exactly 23 years from today. We took this picture. 23 years from today.
Wow, that's really spooky. That is really spooky.
Yeah.
1994.
94.
The year I graduated.
That's right. And then and then Jake started working at House of Music.
Mm-hmm.
And we were playing together just as a duo. And, like, we had friends filling in on as a band. And then one day Jake said, hey, I know this guy Lopaka. I work with him at House of Music. You know, he can maybe teach our friend how to play. And then Lopaka came to my house and he started playing. I'm like, let's get this guy. What are we doing with our... So then we have another picture. This is a nicer picture. It's a more normal. But then the trio. Then we make the trio. We're all three of them. So yeah. So it's been a long road, man. It's been a long road.
Our teeth were really white.
I know. We weren't old enough to drink coffee back then, and you know, right? So thank you for being here, but it's also for us very fun because, you know, we get to reminisce a little bit, too, by playing all these songs. So this one's going to be an instrumental by Jake. We'll play it by Jake, and then we'll go from there. All right. Okay.
Thank you.
Cakes from a Bufuro, everybody. Cool, man. All right. Okay. I feel like we're all loose now. We're all ready to go. And I'm going to invite Lopaka to join us up here, I think.
This was one of the, I remember when we were rehearsing this at John's house, you know, Lopaka was like, oh yeah, I got an idea for this song. And he picked up one of his drums and he put it on his lap and he just started playing this thing. And that was the first time I've ever seen anyone play the drums like that. So, but since then he's kind of evolved into playing the djembe here. And he's just like, you gotta hear this drum, it's just amazing. He makes this thing sound like an entire orchestra. It's really incredible, so check this out.
Aloha, kan
Lopaka Cologne, everybody.
And John Yamasato on the guitar solo.
Hey, right on. In rehearsal, they were like, "You want a guitar solo?" I'm like, no. But we worked something out. Hey, Mike, getting a little bit of feedback. I can come down in my monitor a little bit, I think, on the guitar. So the other thing that we learned about Lopaka is that he does these bird calls. Which his father used to do back in the Martin Denny band, so... Anyway, the song...
Let's send this one out to Lopaka's family.
Yeah, let's do that.
His family's all here tonight.
Yeah.
Song called Molokai Sweet Home.
Molokai in the house.
On your silent shore, reminisce that sweet embrace of ginger. As New York City walls closed in, I long for the touch of an island. Molokai, Molokai. Your weary eyes, missed your smiles and lullabies in the evening time. It's been so long since I've been home, missed your morning sunrise of the countryside. Gone so far to find my way, this time I think I'll stay with my love. Molokai, Molokai, sweet ginger. As New York City walls closed in, I long for the touch of an island. Molokai, Molokai. Sweet home. Molokai, Molokai.
Check it in.
So, you know, growing up playing the ukulele, my mom, you know, she was actually my first ukulele teacher. And she's here tonight, as well as my dad and a lot of family. We have so much family here tonight. All my uncles and aunties are here, and my high school friends are here, and Lopaka has his family here, John has his family here. So it's been so nice, you know, such a, I don't know, just I feel 20 years younger right now.
But you look 20 years younger too.
But you know, growing up, there were just so many great ukulele players that inspired me. I mean, starting with, you know, the great Eddie Kamai, you know, to Peter Moon, Troy Fernandez, Kelly Boyd de Lima, you know, Jesse Kalima, Gordon Mark. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. And Ota-san was always one of my heroes, you know, and my dad, my mom, you know, who, you know, we're both here. They had an awesome, like, record collection, vinyl collection. And I remember listening to Ota-san's records over and over and over. And one of my favorite songs that he wrote was a song called Bodysurfing that he recorded years ago. And I remember, you know, when I was a student over at Roy Sukuma's, I remember like, oh man, this is such a cool song. So we started playing that one because it was such a great uke tune. So we're going to play this one for you. Here's one called Body Surfing in honor of the great Ota-san, one of our great heroes. So. Thank you.
Oh my God. Jake constantly says, hey, don't go too fast, okay? Don't go too fast, okay? And then he's the one who started the tempo, and I was like, oh my God. This is gonna be ridiculously fast. All right, well, we made it. We made it to the end, I guess. It's okay. So, all right. Right on. Oh, yeah. Still got it, guys. Still got it.
My arm was cramping up on that one.
Holy smoke. Okay, so this next song, we really have not done this in, I'd say, at least 17 years. And I get requests for it all the time, and I'm like, I am not qualified to do this without these guys, because they make up half the song, you know? So we're going to try it now, and it's been a while. This is the only song that we did live on our first CD. So, like, there was, like, nothing. We just put a microphone in the middle of the room, and that's how we recorded this, I remember. But we had a good time with it, so we just decided to leave it on the CD. That's how crazy it was back then. It was just like, that sounds all right. Well, put it on the CD. We have nothing to lose. So, yeah. So this is a song. And you'll know it when you hear it. Jake's trying to stall and rest. Mr. Sancho. Got plenty lychee, plenty lychee, but he no gives to me. And he's just a mean old pake man.
Marquise, what are you going to steal my lychee for?
You tell him.
Mr. Conrad Jones got plenty swimming pools. Plenty swimming pools, but he no gives to me. And he's just a mean old howling man.
Hey, you local varmints, get out of my pool!
Yeah. Oh boy. Mr. Maximo Concepcion. Got plenty fighting chicken. Got plenty fighting chicken, but he no gives to me. And he's just a mean old Pilafino man.
I suppose maybe I go take my chicken home and cook it out. Yeah.
That was the best one yet. That was the best one yet. Mr. Kazuo Tanaka. Got plenty camera supply.
Ooh, yes, gosh, yeah.
Got plenty camera supply, but he no gives to me. And he's just a mean old Japanese man.
Ake bono!
That's my people.
You know what's funny? So many cameras are pointing at us right now, too.
All Japanese, right?
All Japanese, yep. Okay. All right. Miss Momi Lomi Lomi.
Momi Lomi Lomi.
Got plenty experience.
Yes, sir!
Got plenty experience. She know experience me. And she's just a mean old cocktail waitress. All right, okay.
Come on, that's like, come on. All right,
that was a six. Okay. Mr. Kamaka Vivo Ole. Got plenty, not too much of nothing. Got plenty, nothing. He takes it out on me. And he's just a mean old Hawaiian man.
Honey girl, tell Tutu I can't clean you out this week because I'm going to watch Pure Heart tonight at Hawaii Theater.
One thing I went notice about this place, all us guys, we tease the other race.
Yeah, bro, don't tease me.
It's amazing we can live in the same place.
Lopaka.
So now you can understand why I cannot do that by myself. This would not make sense. That's like on the, at the end of this next song we're going to do, people say, oh, why don't you do the rap part? There's a rap part at the end of this song. I'm like, do you really think if I got up and rapped, it would make sense or look like fit the narrative? No. Well, I gave away the next song, but... Yeah, that was great. That went out well. Lopaka. Lopaka impressed me.
Because we had a couple of rehearsals, and when we rehearsed this song, you know, Lopaka wasn't really doing the voices. And we're like, wait, are you sure you're going to do it? Said, no worry. I'm saving it for the concert.
Yeah.
Like, all right.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you had some new ones in there.
Yeah.
That's good.
Finally figured out what I was going to do with Miss Momilomi.
Oh, yeah.
You want to do it now?
Sure.
Okay.
I didn't think so. I don't think so. I ain't got time for that.
That's just right. So this would be our practices for hours and hours. Of...
Yes, sir.
Okay. Oh, all right. Okay. All right.
Well, the Japanese one was always funny.
Yeah, that was good. Because
actually, Lopaka used to do this thing. It was a...
He used to name random cars.
Yeah. He said...
Toyota, Mitsubishi, Hitachi.
That was always good.
That's all the Japanese I know.
Okay, let's go into the next song.
Did I ever say how I feel about you? A thing I never found that easy to do. Things that you do don't need to be heard. Know your actions, baby, speak louder than words. I've got the bottle, bring me a cup, pop the cork and try to turn. When you're empty, I'll fill you up. Drink it down, baby, something comes up. I'm a head and nose, like a steaming train. Foot to the floor, in the driving rain. My head is aching, and my mouth is dry. I've got a thirst that only you can satisfy.
pot, bring me a cup, pop the cork and try to serve. When you're empty, I'll fill you up. Drink happy, the sun comes up.
Here, I got to talk a little bit. First of all, please give a round of applause to the sound guys, the lighting guys, the video guys. This is our first time doing the entire concert. So basically, we just, from nuts to bolts to A to Z, we're covering everything. And it's really hard to coordinate everything. And how about a hand for Dave Kusumoto and the HiSessions crew, because they've been here all day. All day. And a couple of last minute things. Auntie Chrissy did our flower arrangements, which are awesome.
Beautiful.
And it was helped by, we had a sponsorship from Compass Home Loans and Premier Title, and I know that some of them are sitting up there, so round of applause for them for helping make this all happen. Oh yeah, they're gonna kill me if I don't, So we have as you know, we have a CD. It's just a best of CD. So it's all some of our favorite songs that we've put on one album. In putting that together, I made a mistake and I sent the wrong graphics. So there's 16 songs, but on the CD it says there's 15. So all the numbers are mixed up. But I figure this batch will be the collector's batch. You know, like, the one that has the mistake on it. And then we'll fix that, and then those new CDs won't be as worth as much later on, you know? We are gonna be up in the wine room after and signing autographs. And actually, I mean, I was telling Devin backstage, I think like 80% of the people here know us already. So it's just gonna be hanging out with you guys. And we're not done yet though. We're still gonna play a few more songs and stuff, but I just wanted to make sure I got those announcements off the top of my head. Hopefully I didn't miss anything. Oh, Kyle Shimabukuro, thank you. He designed the CD art as well as the shirt art. So if you like the shirt and stuff, for High Life. Yeah, right on, Kyle. Kyle's my fishing buddy. On the like 2 days a year I get to go fishing. He takes me out and we do that. So yeah, we'll continue on now, but thank you for the sitting through the quick commercial.
This is one that actually my brother recorded with us. My brother Bruce recorded with us on the on our second Pure Heart album, and it's a song called Tokada.
Not too fast.
One, two, three, four.
Was your ukulele off? And I screwed up. People know Lopaka is not only trained by his dad, but he was a major in percussion at UH too. So he has a degree in percussion.
Yeah, I think you were the drum major, right?
So after all these years, I finally got an answer because he never liked "Hey Baby," the song. Like whenever we bring it up, he's like, you know, I don't play that. And then he finally told me, he's like, I played that in marching band for like 8 years, and then you guys come along, and then I play up another, like, so, the story all comes together.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay. Well, it's that time of the night. Thanks again, everybody, for coming out, and especially with the, oh my God, I had a heart attack when they announced the McGregor-Mayweather fight on the same day as our concert. I'm like, great. Perfect. It worked out perfectly because everyone got to see the fight and then come to the concert. So it's timing is awesome. Yeah.
Win-win.
All right. We're going to do this song and that's it. I think that's it, right?
You know, before we play this last song, I'm sure Lopaka has a few words too, but, I just want to say that, especially to Jon and Lopaka, you know, growing up, playing music, you know, playing with these guys were some of the best memories in music that I ever had, you know. And it's just, they were my biggest influences, you know, because a lot of times we spend so much time together bringing different music to the table, And, you know, and I always learned so much from both of them. And so to be here doing this together, having fun again, you know, 20 years later, just, it's really, it's it feels so special for us. And
it's fun.
For me. And so I just really want to thank these two guys right here.
Thanks, Jake.
I'm a man of a few words on the mic, but yes, I agree with Jake, pretty much. La misma, dito. Yes. Love you guys, and love all y'all. Mahalo.
And to see, you know, and to also see so many people in the audience, so many people in the local media, so many people, like, you know, just friends and family that used to support us when we used to play on that at coffee shops.
Yeah.
We started out at Java Java Cafe on Kapahulu. And,
that's right.
You know, and the Internet Cafe on University.
I can't even remember the Coffee Cove.
Coffee Cove, like, all, you know, all of you that have supported us, like, way back then, you know, we just can't thank you enough for coming out tonight, seeing, walking through and just seeing so many familiar faces, people that I haven't seen in 10 plus years.
And hopefully we can do this again. Yeah. Thanks. It's honestly has nothing to do with us not wanting to play. It's just trying to get everybody. Like, Anuhe asked about this in January, and here we are in August. So that's how long it took us to get our schedules all lined up. But yeah, definitely whenever we can, we'll try to do
and
this.
How about it for Anuhe and Justin too?
Oh man. Yeah, and Anuhe and Justin.
That was so cool. That brought back a lot of memories.
It sure did.
Hearing Justin, his that opening medley, just I was like, oh. So awesome. All right. Okay, well, I guess here we go. Okay.
Thanks, everybody.
How can I get over trying so hard to move my feet, but it seems I'm sinking deeper. How can I get over? I wanna know,
oh,
I wanna know, nah, nah, nah. How can I get over? Living all my life in sin, I don't know where righteousness will come in. How can I get over? Now that I can't wait no longer, living hard in pain and hunger. How can I get over? I wanna know, oh, I wanna know. Nah, nah. How can I get over? I wanna know, oh, I wanna know. Nah, nah, nah. How can I get over? Sin. I don't know where righteousness will come in. How can I get over? Now that I can't wait no longer, living hard in pain and hunger. How can I get over? I wanna know, oh, I wanna know. Nah, nah, nah. How can I get over? I wanna know, oh, I wanna know. Nah, nah, nah. How can I get over? Nah, nah, nah. How How can I get over? Na na na. How can I get over?
Thanks, everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, Pure Heart! Look at all the people. They're so excited. By the way, you are on Facebook Live right now. So thank you very much for making this a very, very special night. Oh, you don't want to go home yet? You want some more music, maybe? You think so? Forget the 1, 2, 3. Just say Hanaho for me. A little louder. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Pure Heart.
Devin on that phone.
That was Facebook Live, dude. You were supposed to play and not like you ruined the whole thing. You're supposed to just start the music. Now I feel like I gotta talk through this because I got audience people going, what's happening right now? Tommy Silva from TNT Tinting is saying, hey, how come they're not playing? Hi, Uncle Tommy.
Oh, man. I want to send a shout out to Mike Brown and Ray Brown and Mark Agena for all the sound production, just getting all the changeovers so quickly. All set for all the fans. We worked really hard putting all that together. So
back to that sophomore banquet. I sang one, and then Jake played one, and this is the song that he played, and this is the one that he played. When I heard him play it, I'm like, holy cow, this guy's good. He ain't no amateur. Yeah.
We'll see if I can still play it.
Yeah, we'll see if he can still do it.
I think we recorded this on our first Pure Heart record, and it was just it was a song that we would usually end our shows with, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And it was a little takeoff of an old Ledward Kaapana tune called Juss Press. And you know, he was one of our heroes growing up, of course. And
yeah.
With Hui Ohana and all that. But
so the arm.
When we had the first rehearsal, I couldn't even get through half of the song. I was like, my arm was dying.
So Jake was punching bag, pushing the rice, you know.
Pushing the
rice. You know, then they go in the thing and they put their hand in the rice to like toughen their arm.
Oh, I guess so, yeah.
I don't know what you call that, but.
Okay, John,
that's
the
Hanahu
is kind of going off the rails over here, bro. We gotta.
All right.
Oh, man. You know what's really cool is the last time we played together, I mean, you know, before we went our separate ways, the last time we played together, you know, we were all three of us were single, you know, we had no idea what we were doing. And so to come together now, you know, and we're all married, we all have kids, and you know, it's just such a different feeling, but it's cool,
still
man.
Fun.
It's like three dads playing together.
Yeah.
Having this history, you know. Really incredible.
At least Lopaka can still wear the sleeveless shirts. He's still got his arms are still toned, you know?
Yeah, dude, you look good.
I know,
man.
Geez, what's going on?
Gosh, I'm gonna wear a long sleeve shirt next time. No, okay, well, let's.
Okay. You can do it, man.
Let's give it a try.
No,
all right, I'm gonna try.
Thank you.
Lopaka, Pure Heart. Bruh. Bruh, where are you? Go over here. Go to the front. Go to the front of the stage. Go say hello to everybody. Just wait. They're standing up for you, man. Pure Heart, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a long time coming. We are so, so happy that you joined us tonight. Okay, now the cameras, you can take pictures. They're right there. Can like shop, Photoshop yourself inside, or take someone up the upstairs area. Go. So, they all stood up and they don't want to leave yet. So, can we? Can we? It doesn't matter what time it is. It's early yet. Okay. 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 If we get them, because this is totally unplanned. I promise you, it's totally unplanned. Go. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. If we can get them to play one more song, you guys are gonna have to lose your minds again. Can you do that? Can you? You sure? This was so awesome an evening. Thank you very much, HiSessions, for putting this together. Did you have a good time? All right. So we are hoping it's not gonna be another like 20 years before they do another one of these. And I get the feeling you will all sign up to come see the show next time too, right? All right.
We gotta come up with some new songs.
How about an encore?
Yeah, they gotta come up with new songs, record some new stuff. That'd be cool. Okay, do you guys have it figured out yet? Can I leave now?
Something.
You got something?
Okay. Yeah, I got something.
Okay. We got something.
You're not gonna do like a slow lullaby song or something, right?
We got a slow lullaby song.
Oh, right on. Okay, well, I will leave you in the very capable and wonderful hands of Pure Heart!
When we used to do like the bar gigs and stuff, this is good. Like, sing along if you want to.
People smile and tell me I'm the lucky one, and we've just begun. Think I'm gonna have a son. He would be like she and me, as free as a dove. Come share the love. The sun is gonna shine above. Even though I ain't got money, I'm so in love with the honey, and everything will bring a change in love. In the morning when I rise, bring a tear of joy to my eyes and tell. His Virgo rising, it is a very good sign. Strong and kind, and a little boy's mine. Now I see a family where there once was none, and we've just begun. Yeah, we're gonna fly to the sun.
Here, last one.
Even though I ain't got money.
rest of the weekend.
Pure heart, ladies and gentlemen. How was that? All right. I'm sorry. It's late. They're going to tow your car away. We have to go. Did you have a good time? Thank you so much for coming out tonight. Give yourselves a hand. Mahalo. Thank you to High Sessions, to High Life. We appreciate you guys coming down. Please get home safely or drive recklessly. Just make sure you get home before everybody else. My name is Devin Nicole. I'm on air on 94.7 Kumu in the mornings from 5 to 10. Got to get in my little plug. If you listen, thank you. If nothing I did tonight was entertaining, good evening. My name is Stephen Uehara. We hope to see you again soon. Please, another nice hand for Justin Young, for Anuhea, for Pure Heart, for our gang at High Sessions, for our friends at the Hawaii Theater, and all of you. Till we see you again. Aloha no, ahui ho, good night.